we're on page Nun Aleph, and it's Seder Netilas Yadayim Shel Chakras. And then he says, Gavonis HaBracha Atzma, hate to understand that. So now it's the Atta Devar Seder Netilas Yadayim Shel Chakras. Atta Devar HaRav Eil Hu HaSeder Shel Netilas Yadayim Chakras. So he said, when a person gets out immediately when he gets up, and he said, take the kli of the water with your right hand. And then you put it in the left hand. Then you pour the water out from the left hand and put it onto the right hand. Al yado yomonis, you pour it on the left hand, on the right hand. Okay, I got to slow down a little bit. I got moving too fast. Hine rabamayim heim meimi achesed. Water is lashon chesed. V'gadei laharel shachayomer mishuhu achesed who gover, in order to show that the right hand is the most important. V'chein defida kushashof rabamayim. So therefore, even when you start to pour the hand, the water in the hands, and you're going to pour at the beginning, the first pour is going to be on the right hand. It's not enough just to pour it on the right hand, because it's the left hand that's really making it possible for the right hand to be washed. The so therefore we find like this, that the power of the washing shall yad yamim ba mitzad yad small. So therefore, you would see that the power is coming from the left hand. V'kadei the sakan gam azel. So in order to be able to make sure that the left hand does not become dominant, tzarch betechilu ba'orach b'se yamim. So therefore, you have to arouse the right hand ayidei sheyikach as a kli, by taking the kli imamayim b'yad yamim, with the water in the right hand. So he said, so therefore the process begins with the right hand, as you take the kli in your right hand and put it in the left hand. So that power of the right hand starts everything going. So therefore the right gives to the left, so that the left can take care of the right. So this, he goes through this. The order is maskil biyamim al yadecha shenoisin akli b'techile biyad yamim. So first the kli goes in the right hand. The yad yamim no sanas akli liyad the smallest. Kadei shecha yad the smallest. Tito esi yad yamim. Yamonis. So therefore the leader over here is the right hand. So the makuf samach beis va'achakach yishpoch mayim yadecha yamonis al yadecha smallest, and you pour it on the from the right. First you take for the right, you put it in the left, then you pour from the left onto the right, and then you pick it up on the right and you pour it onto the left. Take the kli with your right hand, as we know, and you pour it then on the left. That's one time. Going to Kuf Samach Dal, V'choizer v'kaseder chazecha b'pam sheni v'shlishi, and you do this actually three times. V'choizer v'lokeach ha'kli b'yad smol, v'noitol ha'yamim pam sheni, v'achakach lokeach ha'kli b'yad yamim, v'noitol yad smol pam shniya, do it a second time, v'achakach lokeach ha'kli b'yad smol, v'noitol yad yamim pam shlishi, you do it a third time, v'achakach lokeach ha'kli b'yad yamim, and you take it in the right hand, v'noitol yad smol is pam shlishi, and you just keep going the same process. Now over here is where he gets to the part where it has this name. Ba'ofen shatir chatz kol yad v'yad shloshu pa'amim. It comes out that you do this three times each hand. B'seder chazel nimse shakol yad v'yad tir chatz shloshu pa'amim. So if you do it this way, you find that each hand it manages to get washed three times. V'lo sir chatzam yachad, you can't do them all three at one time. Shlosh upam in kol yad, do them three times, bop, 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 and then you go to the other one, bop, bop, bop. El upam achad b'yad zil, but one time on this hand, pam b'chamecheir b'yad hasheni, b'sarugim, so you have to do it alternatively. So he said, say the rechitza shekatzav rab sheyesh lito yadav shlosh pa'amim. I'll call yad v'yad, so that you're going to see this in every hand. Hand davka b'sirugim, but it has to be alternative or alternating. Pam achas ad yad yamim v'la acharacha yad small. So you go right, then you go left, and back and forth. V'acharkach pam shnia yad yamim v'acharacha v'achar yad small. V'acharkach pam shlishis yito. Yad yamin v'achracha yad small. Okay. Yayidei kach, because this way, ruach hatuma, hanikra, and he gives the name of the ruach hatuma. So shin yud beis, taf aleph. Just looking at it, it's very similar to the word Shabbos. And there's two other letters in it, which are yud and aleph. So what's pshat? It's something like shev, something like that. So he says that this name, which I'm not going to pronounce, is the Bas Melech. She's the princess. Bas Melech, she's the princess. A mekapedes of the delegates, and she jumps the kofetzes ad she nisat shenatekes the gamre misham, and she keeps jump. She's a jumper, and she keeps jumping around from one hand to the next until you're actually able to remove her completely. And if you don't do that, in that tekes, so this tuma is still hanging on to you. So also you could find this in the Zohar Tzelem. So it's a little meat coming up. It says, so if you use through the derech of the right hand, small, so in other words, you do all three with one hand and then all three with the other hand, this won't get the tuma off of you. But this tuma jumps from one hand to the next. So it takes three times. Now he doesn't give an explanation why three. I mean, we could think about three because we know there's the lines. You have the right line, left line, center line. Maybe that's an answer. It's only after we do this, the sirugim in alternating hands, daika he Mr. Lakis. That specifically is the only way to get rid of her. The Gemara says like this. He says, time the Rabbi Nelson Omer. Rabbi Nelson says, bas choyim. I try to think, what does this mean? She's a free girl. She's a free daughter. So what does it mean? She can't be captured. She's very difficult to capture. And very strict about, I don't know, I'm not sure what bas choring means, but obviously it means she's free. And she keeps jumping around until you actually get it. She stays in the game, so to speak, until you get her three times. Because of Rashi writes on this, Vazel Shono, Bas Chayim he, this is his language, Bas Chayim. So HaRuach HaShora Al HaYadayim Lifnech HaNetila, so that Ruach that's on the hands, so HaRuach HaShora Al HaYadayim Lifnech HaNetila, so that she is this Ruach Tuma that's on the hands before the person washes. And the Kapet is B'ditilasa. Now, I'm translating mekapedes as like kaped, you know, a kaped where she jumps. I don't know what mekapedes means. I thought I knew, but I'm not sure. But it's ilasa. Nanotach yatha ashi yishbach miyad yatha shlosh pa'amim al yadav. In other words, she stays there. You can't get rid of her until you do this three times. Now, over on the previous page, he has a little blurb over here in the Shefa Kavanos, a number Yud Bet. Number Yud Beck says, ki al yedei ke ruach atuma hanikra, and he gives the name again, bas melachi, she's a princess. And the kapedes, the delegates, and she jumps, the kofetzes, she jumps, ad shenis atekes the gamre misham, that's his phrase, until she keeps jumping back and forth until you actually get rid of her. The imraf ainin atekes, if you don't do it this way, she can't be removed. Yedua shahatuma agadola biyosir. So this, understand, is this a tremendous tuma that you're talking about here. He agaiva. What is her nature? She's arrogant. What's gaiva? What's proud, arrogant? what's a guy that she's boastful and can do whatever she wants. And this nasty nida, is really the guy, the dick of person, the proud, bold person who's really happy with himself. Hashem hates this. And Sha'am Rechazal Besot, until the Zohar says, the Gemara says, Shekol Adam Sheyesh Bo Gassas and Ruach, anybody who really thinks too highly of himself, the Hain the Gaiva, that's what he calls Gaiva. Amar Kodesh Baruch Hu, Ein Ani V'hu Yecholim Lidor Be'olim, that he and I cannot stay in the same world. V'kol Zohar Bekum Machmas Godel Tuma, because of the tremendous amount of Tuma, Hashara Ansel Ha'adam Amizgaya, because there's a tremendous person who makes himself look like he's great, or feel great, from, I'm not sure I got the right English words for this, Ha'adam Amizgaya, because a person who, this boastful person, or keep looking, Mimelech Kedusha Barachas, so therefore what happens is that this kind of guy that causes the Kedusha, Mr. Lekas, to leave Mifnei Hatuma in the presence of this Tuma. While Derek Aremes Evshalom Ahocha, so then you could say like this: Shekasher Adam Kam Baboker. When a person gets up in the morning, he says Oz Ruach Atuma Shora Al Yadav. Then there's this Ruach Atuma that is now resting on his hands. Now I don't know if we saw this here, if we saw this somewhere else, or we saw it previously of how Shef of Kedusha is rolling down to the fingertips, and this is where I guess we saw that. And this is where the tuma attaches. Ruach tuma hazuha behi agayva. This is this pride, this false pride. V'lechein nikras ruach tuma hashora al hayadayim bas melech. So because of this, the idea is I'm so important. Maybe egoistic is a good word. He says that I'm so important because I am a princess. Shuhu Lashon Gaiva, because calling yourself somebody special, thinking of yourself as better than others, that is a tuma called Lashon Gaiva. V'zeha v'gaiva, so this gaiva, Hashora al Gedayim Daika, that is really specifically designated onto the hands. Haino Hamachshavos, then we were talking about the way a person in his heart, he thinks, so this is like the idea, they also use that word about certain Israelis that think that they do it all themselves, or this is a problem with people in general. Ki kochi in my power, the otzim yadi, in the strength of my hand, also li esachayel, is of this prophet that I'm making here, this great, is because I'm great. Like he is in charge, and that he is actually going to do whatever he wants. This all happens because of advice that this person gets from the Yetzirah, Hamatel Gaiva Beleva Adam, who plays this ego egotistic attitude in men. And for this, machniyim as the gaiva. What we're doing here in this is we're humbling down this gaiva shal bas melech of the princess. Ayudecha begalus. Ayudei galus, galus, through exile, I guess. Is that what he means? Vizecha b'mayushihi enana bas melech. And when you show her that, it's as if she's not really a bas melech. So they really start pouring the waters and serugim from one hand to the next. She has the ability and the strength to be able to lead you three times. But now we have the concept of three times, and I guess maybe it's giving an answer here. So you have a chazaka there. So if you do three times, then you're actually kolomar. So that you get rid of her, she falls into, in other words, she leaves your hands, I guess. If you do it three times, because it's a chazaka, it's a position then. By your day came, and through this way, he rilasha, he and Nana Basmelo, she shows she's really not the princess and can stand strongly and do whatever she wants to. Shahabi hi holechas begalus, because now she's going into exile, she's being removed. Vayidekach, again came in this way, he nechnas v'holecha, she becomes humbled, and she leaves. And mekan derech ma'amusur l'kol adam. So the Tev writes, and this is where we can see some musur for a person. Hech yesh lehisrachek ma'agai, but how important it is for a person to keep himself away from egotistical thoughts. V'leilech begalos, and then wind up being exiled. This is the first thing that you have to do in the morning, is to remove the yeshus from yourself. In order to humble down this mida of being proud about your ego, egotistical. Because this is really a tremendous root or base for the corruption of the midos. V'davka ha'adam ha'mashpil atzmal, that this is only about a person who humbles himself, who asher karev l'Hashem Yisbarach. So this person, that's the person that becomes close to Hashem Yisbarach, k'moshen emar, like we say like this, Meron, the Most High, the Kadosh, Eshkol, and that's where I will dwell, of as Daka v'shafa ruach. So this, we're talking about a person who's low in his own thinking. Hashem Yisbarach yizakenu, Hashem Yisbarach will give this person schus l'shiflos ruach be'emes, a real, real humble ruach. Amen. Ken Yiratzon. Okay, so that's where I'm going to stop right now, and we'll move on to the next topic. This is a little sidelight into the concept of why we wash our hands in the morning. Okay, let me try to move real fast, and I'm not marking my place as well. Okay, let me.